So how long are you with me?
As long as you want.
Yes?
Okay. Thank you. For sure, I know one thing, that next year, next week, it will have not service here. This for sure. Okay. Thank you for warm greetings and for greetings warm, having me. Thank you for into. I am so not so important and very known person. I don't know who, from where you have this information. Nevertheless, I am happy that I can be among you. And you know, you have today challenge because I'm speaking Polish and English, which is Pinglish. And I don't know how it's worked this. Anyway, I am Irek Czubak. I have a wonderful wife, Marila, and she and me, we have four children, and we are working actually 29 years with Michael. Actually, Michael, I know Michael before I met my wife. No, I knew my wife before. But we are like also have with Michael anniversary, 29 years to know each other and work with each other in former Soviet Union and help. Dear friends, because I know there's so many information what I would like to share with you, but I don't know if you will be able to hear me. First of all, I would like to say thank you for these years when you are helping Hevra, and that we can help Jewish people, and especially in former Soviet Union, especially now in Ukraine. And about this, I will speak. Actually, I wanted to share something about the Parshat Torah, but you did already. But what was really amazed me in this Parshat Torah? Maybe I will just say a few words about it, if you don't mind. Yeah. First of all, then Moshe. This is the Matot. Yes, we'll start from the chapter 40, Bamidbar. The Moshe spoke to the heads of the tribes of the people of Israel. He said, "Here is what Adonai has ordered: when a man makes a vow to Adonai and or formally obligates himself by swearing an oath, he is not to break his word, but is to do everything he said he would do. And for me, like somebody who is from the Gentile way, yes, I am not trying to be Jewish, even I have a kippah, you see. But I am really happy to know you, because I started to come here. Yeah, actually it was Columbus. Good. From this year, 23 years ago. And Messianic leaders really give me great impact to understand the Jewishness of my faith. So what it says here, and I am studying, I'm trying to understand, because you know you are smarter, you are no matter. Than us, but we Gentiles were following this to knowing what is this, what is important for us in this scripture, and I will tell you to where I am going. To that vow, it's like one rabbi says this and one rabbi says this. Yes, some rabbi says I read that this is like something that you are obligated to do, but somebody says can do. But I was small, I have 12 years old or 13. I didn't hear in Sinai. Yeah, but there's they said amen for everything. What Moses says. Help your neighbor. Love your neighbor. And it's amazing word in Hebrew there that descendants of Israel was saying, but not only them. But the future descendants, and all together, this is amen. Why is this important for us, my dear friends? Because today we are responsible for neighbors, and we are like a Poles today. We are responsible for Ukraine because they are not our neighbors. Of course, it's not Ukraine is not close to states, but states is also helping. But the situation what has happened, and I will speak afterwards, push us to not turn the face from it. not. Because this is the vow. And we should to do how we can. Some people say, yeah, but we have today 21st centuries. Some of these things not working. This is always the stories. Sometimes people would like to excuse themselves. But thank you for this, that you are faithful. For many years, we come with Michael and we can do things which is unbelievable. Not because we are great, but because he is faithful. He is great. Adonai, Hashem. So, the next part was of this Parshat Torah, you know everything, war with Midianites, you can say.
Midianites.
Oh, this is the word. Yeah, I have to learn it. All the men from Israel side, they've been unclean after the war. And I think war is not good. And this is what I see, and I will share afterwards about Ukraine. It's also some part what uncleanness. There is not people who are clean there. And we have to understand. And it's a big price of people who are dying and those who are suffering. And the next part is the also very interesting story about the descendants of Reuben and Gad. This is very important for me because I find, you know, when I'm reading this Parshat Torah, always I think this is a story about me. Because exactly is this, I am the, in the, this is the, that's why I'm famous, because I am there. Why? Because it speaks like this. The descendants of Reuben and descendants of Gad had vast quantities of livestock. When they saw the land of Jazer and the land of Gilead were good for livestock. When they saw. And when I see many things, when we see, immediately we like it, we love it. We already plan our life. Is like Reuben, and God did it. Thanks God that they made vow that they will come back, that will be coming with Israel and help the other tribes. And Yeshua said also, you view, see, and think you did it. It's not enough that you have to sin. It's not enough that, oh, it only in my mind. No. The fighting is here, because if you think and you receive this bad thought, you already did. So this is also because of our work and because of the be Tsar of the nations, to see perspective to people who will be under us. This is all about this war also, what we are witnesses of what happened today. And the next thing, what is for me important, that for these years, to trying to be kind, to learn how to be kind. This is like all process with us to learn. And Torah is great instruction for us, for me personally. It's to learn and remember, Zachor. In other words, Zachar. I am not Hebrew speaking, it's something. But this is the word which is give us opportunity not forget this what happened. And then the next part of the story will be in this Parshat Torah, how every detail Torah speaks about what happened with Jewish people when they let go from that God give them let go from Egypt. Why is important? Why is important? Remember, Zachar, Zachor. Because this is give us idea that not we are so perfect and great, that he is great. And I will see myself 23 years ago, if I will analyze me, how stupid I was. And I don't know how my wife could marry me. This is the big miracle. But it happened to me. Thanks God. Because she is wise. I mean, the best part of family is in Krakow. I am the one who came here. I try to that you will like me still. Anyway, this is what is important. Not forget. And we, like Hevra, like Foundation Polania, cooperate with Hevra. We not only giving the food, but we would like to bring dignity. A remembering of these lost tribes of Israel, that's all lonely Jewish people there, and especially there where is the today war. We commemorate just recently in Krakow the Jewry, the Jewish people who've been killed in our land. And maybe I should read something about the great rabbi, Krakow rabbi. There's the Moses ben Israel Izerles, Remu, 17th age, wonderful, absolutely wise man. They said also holy. I haven't met him, but if they say, I should say, but I'm absolutely number one of rabbis in Krakow, or Krakow could have. He said something like that. If God hasn't given the Jews Poland as a place of refuge, the fate of Israel would have really been unbearable. Why Zachor? Why remember? Because this what bring us together. The Poles and Jews. 1,000 years, the same story. The same. Different people in the same land. We create in 2014 the Foundation Polania, we established that the name Polania mean Pol here, Lan, dream, stay, Yahweh. This was what Jewish people called our land. Rabbi says it was legend that when they escape from Spanish Inquisition, from England, from France, from Germany, they find the land and they called our land. Here dwell Yahweh. Yah. And this is for us responsibility what we have today. This land will bring blessing or curse? And many things, this is not our business. But I think, and we did from 2016 up to 2019, up to the pandemic time, we did four big, just to for your information, not because we are so big and so famous. He is big, he is famous. We did four marching with the mayor of city, with ambassador of Israel, asking for forgiveness all Jewish people who've been treated by Poles in badly way, pogroms during the 800 years. And of course, we know that Nazis, the Germans came and they did for us concentration camp. We didn't ask them, but they came. Why? Because we had the biggest diaspora before there were 3.5 million Jewish people was living in Poland. That's why Hitler was able to do this, because almost all Jewry in Europe was in Poland. But for us, for the new generation today, is to remember, not turn the face, remember. And God is repeating the same story. This is same today, Ukraine. I'm not speaking that Ukraine is chosen people, but I'm speaking God is giving us today the same examples to learn. Israel was so close to promised land. And what happened? They started what? they forget what God did for them in Egypt. They forget who are they. They forget, and this is what is it's really making crash in our family, in our mind, that we forget that we have this everything for free, that we have peace, that we have everything, like I wake up and you have everything. I know we have problems. I know that we need not have a nice projector. It's good, right? Yeah. I need a new dress. Of course I need it. Yeah, many things I need. But we forget, and that's why God is giving us the examples of your people. Exactly, I am behaving like them. Why? Because we are built like this. We need him close. And that's why something happened, things around us. And I am begging you, don't turn your face and say, this is not my business. Because this may be things will teach you and heal you, your inside. When we started to work with Michael, I have many problems, especially with that speak with him, because he didn't speak Polish. Still he doesn't. No, he does some word. But we have great joy to serve together. It was for us fun. You think Ukraine or Russian was so nice country? No. Because the people and the heart of these people we have seen, and for us was full of joy to come. Even we have not water, hot water, maybe. We have not good conditions. Doesn't matter. But the power of his presence is more than this. So, dear friends, I will tell you, I was speaking before the war in Ukraine, one Ukrainian church. And you know what I said to them? The church, amazing church, they have not Sunday services. They have on Shabbat. They said, it's written in the Bible. More things. I came with Israelis, secular Israelis, with the mayor of city of Kiryat Haim, and I said, listen, there is the people who celebrate like Jews, but they are not Jewish, but they honor Israel. And they've been shocked. The Israelis have been shocked. They came, they see the big flag of Israel, they hear the Jewish Hebrew songs in Hebrew, Ukrainian, and this mayor of city said, Irek, why this happened? I said, they love your country. And this church is helping also to bringing Jewish people back to Israel. So I said, just before the war, few months, I said, you know, I have for you information. The situation is like this, and I didn't know what I'm speaking about. That is pessimist and optimist. Pessimist says, worse cannot be, and optimist can be, says, could be, can be, maybe worse like this. And in next few 6 months, they have war. Nobody expect. Nobody was thinking about it. Dear friends, when we speak about the war, we think, oh, you know, this ancient time, you know, who understand this? Midianites, yeah? Midianites? Why we need this to read? You know, it's full of blood. This is the Old Testament. I am telling you, we are coming to the place that we will be witness of that. Not because I am prophet, but because your prophet says so. Read Malachi, Zechariah. What will be with Jerusalem? What will be with the old army? Where they will go? With whom to fight? Ukraine, for me, is perfect example for this, what God is preparing. It's coming time. Sorry to say so, I am not a tragic prophet. I am not prophet at all. But I am telling you, be grateful for each day. If you if you wake up, say, you know, this prayer. Mode anile fajnecha melecha kwaikam shekanata binishpati bechem lara emunatecha. Rabbi, in our home, Rabbi of Krakow comes and teach us Torah and Isaiah. Never happened before. And I said, why? I said, because, he said, because I see in your heart you are wonderful people. We would like to teach you. And my rabbi from New York was forbid me to teach Goyim. But you, I would love to teach. Could you imagine that? And he's teaching us, and I'm thinking, Rabbi, I have many messianics, they are my friends. He said, really? I said, yes, but I love them. They teach me so many things. I'm doing many things together. And I said, because we, that is written here, I'll tell Enya, that we've been far away. Yeah, I read you this already, Isaiah, Ephesians, I read? No, so I will read you this. I read this rabbi, Orthodox rabbi from Krakow. Therefore, remember, you former state, you Gentiles by birth, called by uncircumcised, you were stranger from the national life of Israel. You were foreigners of the covenants embodying God's promise. You were in this world without hope, without God, with the promises and covenant. But because of Yeshua Messiah, in his blood, you are close. And I thought always that we are close to God. But in original in Greek, it speaks close to Jewish community. And it was forced me to think, like a non-Jews, my church is really close to the Jewish community or not? Or we are making division? Oh, with Messianic, we are close. Yeah. Yes, we are close. But do we close like non-Jews with synagogue? Somebody cares about this? And I said to the rabbi, I would love to be close with you. I would love to be close with my brothers Messianic. And he said, where is this written? I said, you know, Rav Shaul, I know you don't believe that, but for me, he was Jewish, he wrote this to us, to Goyim. That we are obligated to be close to the Jewish community, what we missed. So many things church missed for the thousands of years. To separate themselves and separate roots. You know that, I will not speak about. But, dear friends, this is miracles. That's why we have to analyze our life. I know we have problems enough. I know that life is not easy. Yeah? But compare things what happened in the East. When I'm coming to the places that the bombs comes, I see these ladies, also Jewish ladies, and they are crying. Why this happened to me? We've been living so many years. We've been like a babies. We've been like a brothers. Ukraine, Russia, and what? Why he is doing this for us? For what? We, Poles, as Rebbe Israel says, Remu, we have thousands or millions of Jewish people, and we also did bad. But God says, if you are unclean, come and clean yourself. So easy. If you did something against your friend, against your wife, just go and manage. Manage. Just, this is the normal work. I don't care about my emotions. I have emotions, yes. But if I hurt myself sometimes, I was now in Israel, and we've been in desert, in close Arad, with Messianic leader. He took us, you know, to desert. And I have my son, and his son was with me, and we've been sitting in the desert, and they said, he asked, What do you hear now? Nothing. What you can hear in desert? Yeah? Nothing. And suddenly my son says, "Yes, I know what I hear. I hear myself." And he said, "This is the point. We have to listen ourselves. We have to hear us. What is here?" And sometimes between this voice comes his voice. But we are so busy. We have so many things. We have so many important things in the world. And like we are people of the world, we are not. He is Messiah. He is a God. He is the one. And we have to follow him, dear friends, not because we have to, because it will be for us the great benefit if we will be following him. So, about us. Hevra USA, no-profit charitable organization, collects humanitarian aid from international donors, delivering food with local grassroots network, hard-to-reach recipients in Ukraine. After Russia's full-scale invasion of Ukraine 2022, the foundation pivoted the focus all but exclusively on helping Ukrainians, refugees, internal immigrants, and small rural communities near the front line. I am one more thing what happened to Poles this time, that we've been coming all of our friends, no friends, to the border without any sign from government. Most Polish people, the moment the war started, we came and we started to serve to our friends and our neighbors. And this is the obligation. And I was happy first in my life. I was proud of my land. I said, this is what has to be. This is what should we do with Jewish people always, to stand, and we are still doing, trying to teach people and to showing how loving kindness and mercy is important. You can pray, okay, I am not against the prayer, but if you want to do nothing, your prayer is useless, yeah? So, first time in my life I was happy. So the next thing what happened, Hevra, and you people from States, you were helping us very much, that we've been able to bring the help to the lonely mother with children, to bring them to the Poland, to send also and to give the parcels for the Jewish society, communities, and of course that we could be able to bring the thousands of tons through the different with different organization help, and still is not enough, because the conflict will be not finished tomorrow. This is, I'm sorry to tell this. Situation is really bad, and nobody knows when it will be finished. I think, my experience, it will be not because I am bad or good prophet, but it will be for next few years, this conflict. And there is the bombs going to the civilian schools. Just 3 weeks ago, I was with one journalist from New York Times, a Jewish lady. She's retired and she came to Ukraine. It's interesting, yeah? She working with this newspaper and Washington Post, and she came to Ukraine just to serve, to write articles. I said, "Tamar, you could sit in New York. Why you came?" She said, "This is my place." And so we've been 3 weeks ago the place, the center, in some small town close the front line. And 3 days ago, the center is no exist, and people is killed. They send bombs there. Dear friends, it's hope. It's always hope. And I encourage you to be with full of power. And to go forward, to be how God created you, how God is leading you here. We never know what will be in States. We know that antisemitism is growing. We have to be aware where we are living. And we have to be aware that God said so. And this prophecy will fulfill, we would like or not. But, nevertheless, in this all difficult situation, in this all difficult, oh, look at this, this is new, our hope, the new generation, how to teach them to know this, how to give them this faith, our ancestors. Because this is our hope, but nevertheless, hope is always at the front of us, because God is our hope. Because He is giving us power to fulfill this what He said so. So we are asking you for help. And I know I am all, many times I was a witness of this, that God provides food and things and help, and always is remind me this what the Queen Esther says, Mordechai said to her, if help will not come from you. And I would love to always that I could be the one always that help will come from me, because you know why? Because it's bringing you motivation. It's open your heart, and even the darkness, what is new, will instead of this darkness will come light. Because if you are starting to, you know, it's like this. I like this joke. You know, the rabbis have the meeting. You know, many rabbis, and everybody has like 1,000 problems. And first he says the problems, the second, the third, the fourth, and at the end, the fifth, he took his problem and go away. Why? Because when he heard what kind of problem they have, he has not a problem. So always, it's good to see the perspective we have. And always instead to see it and to do nothing. We have so many sickness, psychological sickness. We have so many problems, this our Western civilization. But you know what the most problem is? Because we are closed society, we don't want to help anybody. We would like to be alone. You know, it's like this faith in Trinity, you know? You have this, yeah? Faith in Trinity, I, me, and myself. This is what we believe today, that we are so powerful, but we are dependent from God, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. God who revealed himself in Mashiach ben David, Yeshua HaMashiach. And he will give us power, and he will come. Even you think your answers didn't come, or you're still waiting for answers, just no, move yourself, go. Maybe you will find the answer when you will help anybody else. Maybe do something for Ukraine. Maybe do something. I've been 3 weeks ago in Gaza, close Gaza, not in Gaza. It's impossible to be in Gaza for us. And it's the same problem. The leader, which messianic leader who showed us, like we've been like 2 kilometers to see Gaza from the world. And he showed me and said, you know, anytime could rockets come to Sderot. And we have, but those people have hope. They are helping the other. In this old darkness, we can see the people and what kind of the heart they have. And I am not hero. I am not really here. They say, "Oh, you are hero. You are going to the place. There's bombing." No. I try to come there because I see this give me changing my character, changing my life, changing my understanding about even myself. It's my life, because if I will be sitting, I will be really stack-neck guy who will only believe in Trinity. You know, yeah? I, me, and myself. But because you're moving, because you're coming, that's why Torah is important to fulfill. Even Israel didn't know why they should to do. And they said, we heard, we do, and after we understand why we've done this. Father is speaking good things to children, will not speak us bad things. You don't need to, like Greek, check it out, everything is just true what he said, because it's true. That's why I am asking you, try to do it. And it will bring you healing. I am not the doctor. If something think that I am a doctor, I am healer. No. I am not also the pastor. Or I am just eyewitness of things what I see in my own eyes for the 30 years almost. And I am. That's why I'm here, to just encourage you. Not saying that you are in. You are how you are. God create you in His image, and He would like that you will have good. You will choose good decision in your life. For your goods. So we're helping in the place when the Kherson, flooding was. We have packages which cost $15 each, and we are able today to give the for children, like for 100 children. But we have 300 children. The same. Only the one thing which is different, that they are there and you are there, you are here. And I was asking myself, why this happened to them, not to me? Where I am better than them? I am not better, even if maybe I am worse. My wife could tell you everything about me. That's why she is not here. Anyway, dear friends, so I know that you have wonderful leader. He knows what to tell you, especially about program for next week. For sure, he is not in a meeting. And for sure you have to register yourself, otherwise you will be in trouble. All things is the front of God. And just small story, because the children came, I will tell you the story that we met one girl, she was 12 years old when we met her, and she's name is Veronica. She's disabled, she's autistic, and we met her. She was living with her family 2 kilometers, I don't know, it's miles, maybe 1.5 mile from the Russians, front line. And the situation of this family was really bad. Mother died some months before. Father has 3 children, she was the 3rd one, disabled. And when we knocked to the door, the children opened us the door, because we bring the help. There is not water, there is not electricity, there is not heating, gas. And we asked, where is father? Where is mom? So mom, they said she died, and father just went somewhere, and we acknowledged that father likes alcohol. So, because we are cooperating with military administration there, ourselves, we have convoy, special convoy to come. We are collecting the gathering parcels, and we go a few cars, and we have to be very strict and very fast, because if the drones of Russia will come, we could have problems. So we come, we recognize that this children are alone, and Veronica is always smiling. Very sweet girl. So after we understood the father was not so far away visiting his friend, and we started to think how we can help them. It's a difficult situation. Children are almost alone, and we would like help. And we, with the police and with the some crew and duties, we started to understand that it's possible that we can find in the next big city some refugee house for them. So we started to work on it, and thanks God, the family and father find himself, of course, and he stopped to drink because he have seen that hope. Because many of these people, they have not hope. And you know, what is different between us and unbelievers? You know what is different? They are the same. Only we have hope and God, and they don't know to whom to sometimes come. This is only the difference. I thought that I am better. For these old years, 30 years, I am better than them. No way. I am the same. But only I know that to whom to turn. I have somebody who is waiting for me. This is my personality, Midrash. I know Josh Brumbach, yeah. He was with us in Ukraine as well. Anyway, so this is not the end of story. Veronica, in this refugee house, she came and she received new clothes, you know, because of such a people like you, who are donate money, who are give the possibilities that we can bring these things to these people. So we see how she's drawing and making and going to. There is also the shelter, and we would like to in this place, refugee house. We would like just to do the renovation, because there is 200 refugees, and most of them, 200, they are children, that they can have also classes under the building, because according to the Ukrainian law, you can if it's the alarm. You cannot teach children, you have to go to the shelter and wait. So almost sometimes during the day, it's like five sirens, five alarms. So they decide to stay and to have classes downstairs. Even sleep downstairs. There is no toilet, not good conditions of life. So we also try to help in this matter. So Veronica, we understood that it's some possibilities to bring family and to give her good medical treatment and doctors, and we are cooperating with many, many organizations, which is good, because this is what we cannot do, some people could do. And we ask some foundation, which is have very good connection with medical system in Poland. They put this family, and especially Veronica, to the place that she can be treated, and with God's help, she could be how is she with wonderful smile, but she can get this what she could in there. So this is Baruch Hashem, because of the end we said we are doing this of the name of God, and we will not press them that they should to believe anything. We said we would like to, but they said, asking me, why you are doing this? From where you have this passion? So I think this is passion not from me. This is the passion from God of Israel, through His Yeshua Messiah, who give life for us. Instead of me, He died. So, dear friends, thank you for being here. Thank you to have me. I don't know if it was clear enough for you. I tried to do my best, but I will tell you, God could be better. God could do better.